my soul fainted. Trials and tribulation upon me, crushing me. The thoughts got to collapse upon him. I earnestly, seriously remember the Lord, and my prayer came to you into your holy temple. Now pay close attention. Verse 8. Those who pay regards, what do you pay attention to? Amen. To false, useless, and worthless idols. Amen. Forsake their own source of mercy. Amen. And loving kindness. So the thing you pay attention to, you pay regards to, is the thing you are what? Trusting, putting your faith on. Right. Are you listening? But when Jonah was in trouble, he remembered. He remembered. The trials and the tribulation is to help you remember you cannot trust nothing but God. In essence, God, the trials and the temptation and everything, it should show to you, tested, there is one stone that is tested. Hallelujah. It is designed to show you there is only one stone you can trust that has been tested. I told you, some of you know, I have a Sri Lankan friend, and he is an Hindu. So he has many, many trouble in his life. And he believes in many, many gods. So I said, okay, there's a simple, I keep telling him about Jesus. He goes, I believe in Jesus, but I believe Jesus is Krishna and a younger or older brother. So I go, okay.
Interesting.
Okay. I go, this is what I want you to do. When the troubles start, I want you to call upon all the gods to help you that you call on. Now, if it's not stopping, then I want you to call to Jesus. He came back a few years. It happened, and I called Jesus, and it all went away. One is a tested stone.
Amen.
The rest may be stones, but they're not what?
Amen, amen, amen. Amen.
So what he did, but I still didn't get to move him and brave him. He decided to use the tested stone for majors and the minors for the regular stone.
Of course.
I'm like, Lord, help. Help.
He needs to grow in knowledge.
He needs to throw away the rest of stones. But in his mind, he can't decide big matters, tested stone. Small matters, I can use my what? Regular stones. Oh, man is a special creature. He needs to throw in the knowledge of the rest of stones.
Yeah.
And increase in knowledge in the tested stone.
Amen.
The only charge of the tested stone, it demands tested what? Faith. Mm-hmm. Ego, I have to be tested, a stone of substance. And I demand your faith be what? Faith of substance. We're going to wrap this up, and I just have two scriptures I want to share with you. I want you to look to two different scenarios. It's the same situation, but I want you to look at what Christ is concerned about with the disciple. This is why he said in Luke 18, when I come back, will I find what? Genuine faith. He goes, I am tested. Will I find faith that has been tested? And you're not going to be able to go, Lord, you didn't give me the experience. No. Every day a blitz is being dialed up. Some suffering, some trial, some health challenge. So if it's not you, it's people around you.
Yep.
I'm a fortunate man in this way. A lot of things God will not normally let come into my life anymore. But the people that connected to me, it's always going on.
Perfect.
So it's always forcing me for my faith to become what? More deeper.
Yeah.
It's always me to gain more knowledge of Jesus, to trust him more. Mm-hmm. You are overcoming in your life, but I want you to overcome it all in life connected to your life.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect. Hallelujah. Which means I have to trust God. I don't know how to do that. I know, but the tested stone
knows. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. You must decrease so the tested stone can increase. I couldn't help my friend in his mind. I go, I'll fix it. I go, I'll tell you what I use. I have a stone that I use. Like other man with the pearl that's rubbish stone, we have one too. It's called Jesus. Hallelujah. We evoke him by faith. I want to show you two things. Go to Mark chapter 4, verse 40. There's two scriptures and then we're done. We got like 5 minutes more. Mark.
Is that that don't experience seafood is like the scripture you read last week where it says the trials were so crushing we despaired even of our life.
Yes.
But that was to get off ourselves.
Yes.
And only trust the
intestine. Yes. Many of us, we laugh at my friend, but many of us is like him.
Yeah.
We trust Jesus for what? The big things.
Yeah.
The one that we know beyond a shadow of a doubt, we can't handle. Jesus, you need to step in. But all the simple matters, dealing with my own health, dealing with my wife, dealing with my children, dealing with your friends, your job, you're like, I got me and my education and my resource for this one. So, you know, my friend is more, you know, a parent the way he's doing it, but we do it too.
Yeah.
It's just more in a little bit of a, you know.
We use the condemned stone.
Yeah, exactly.
We use Adam.
Mark chapter 4:40. He's demoing you. Now, just to understand this story, wait a minute. I can't read all of the story. I'll tell you a little bit of the story, and then I'll just read from verse 37. Jesus tell them, I want you to go across the lake.
Mm-hmm.
He said, I want you to sail across the lake.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when they were going there, the wind, the storms, the temptation, the resistance, the opposer of their trying to cross, amen? Come on. If you know what God fighting with Israel, God tell Israel go to Canaan. When Israel tried to go to Canaan, what happened? All the other tribes start to what? Oppose them. So this is what they decide. We are like grasshoppers. We are like ants and they're like grasshoppers. So we ain't gonna go. God does not happy. When God tell you he's accomplished something, if you won't lay hold of it, he is not happy. Are you listening? So Christ tell them, I want you to cross the lake. Let's see what happened. I'm just going to pick it up from 37. The Bible said, and a furious storm of wind, of hurricane proportion, arose. And the waves kept beating into the boat, so that it was already becoming filled. But he himself was in the stern of the boat asleep. Amen? On the leather cushion. And they awoke him and said to him, Master, do you not care that we are perishing? The way Jesus said, we are going to die. And he arose and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, hush now, be still. And the wind ceased, sank to a rest as if exhausted by its beating. And there was immediately a great calm, a perfect peace. Amen?
Amen.
A perfect peacefulness. Now look at 40. So Jesus get up. So Jesus is sleeping. And he told them sail. And he go, I'm going to rest. The wind stopped them. So then he get up and he deal with the wind. But look what he did next. And many of us, he does the same thing. We come up against a wind. We call him, as we should. He deals with the wind. But look what he does with you next. Look at 40 now. And he said to them, why are you so timid and fearful? How is it that you have no faith, no form, rely, and trust? After he deal with the wind, he go, how could you be so afraid? Because faith and fear can't be in what?
The same
place. There's only one reason why we are fearful. What are you lacking? Faith. So after Jesus deal with the wind, he goes, how come you're such a coward? He goes, didn't I give you a spirit of power? Didn't I say I did not give you a spirit of timidity? Then why can't you deal with this wind? He said, how come you have no faith? This is his disciple. Amen. He said, how is it that you have no faith? How is it? Now Satan, this is his old job. He don't care what else you do. Long as you don't increase with faith. Because you know, only by faith you can make the wind what? Hush.
Mm-hmm.
He said, how come you have no trust in God? Like I will tell you, cross the sea and let the wind destroy you. It's the same story. Go to Matthew 8:26. Then we're going to wrap this up right there. Matthew 8:26. You have to grow in the principle that God set before you. And then start to grow in victory. Amen? And helping us. Matthew 8:26. This is the exact same story, but you'll notice the verbiage is a little different in verse 26. I'm going to read the story again. In the other one, he tells us, how is it you have no faith? In Mark 4:40, you got, how could you be with me, working with me, walking with me, and you have no faith? 26:3. And he said to them, the very same thing, why are you timid and afraid, O you of little faith? Either your faith is just not at mountain status. Either, why is your faith so little? When the fear is rushing in, when you're dealing with situation, you can't tell a Christian in truth they don't have faith. In truth, they what? They have. What you can tell them, their faith is what? Little. It's not mountain faith. And how you know? Here is a storm in their life, and they don't have the faith to what? Shut it down. They can't pull the spiritual rams into the physical. So in Mark 4:40, how come you have no faith? Why isn't it working? This is why Jesus used to go with him. How long must I put up with you, with your lack of faith? How long must I be with you? Why isn't your faith working? There's several reasons why your faith doesn't work. One, as Pastor Chow said, you believe in you. Your faith is in you. There's another one. You believe more in the storm, the attack of the enemy, than what? The Savior and the Creator of the storm. The Creator of the storm. Your faith will not engage if when the storm comes in your life, you believe in the storm more. Your faith will not work if you believe in you more than the one who created you and the storm. Are you listening to what I'm saying? Church, I can't put enough emphasis on this. But I'm telling you, you have to learn to trust God. And if you want to do this, you have to read or listen to the Word of God. You know, I've read my Bible many times, and I preach just about every week, and I'm forever studying. You ask my wife this. You know when you come in my car and you turn on the radio, what do you hear? You know what I listen to most of the time? The Word of God. Is it? I don't know it. Of course I know it. But the more I hear the Word of God, the more my faith is what? Are you listening?
Amen.
Right now I'm listening to the whole Bible again. I've read the Bible more than once. But I'm listening to the whole Bible. Every day I'm listening to some of the Bible.
Amen.
But what I'm telling you, the more I hear the Word of God, the more my what? Faith is increasing. Because I can guarantee, Jesus said, trials, temptation. I know my faith is going to be tested. Because God does not accept unapproved faith. And I know I can't shut the enemy up unless my faith what? Is approved. And I know I will not be able to shut down the situations in my life unless my faith is what? Approved. And please don't think this is a prerequisite. Oh, I hope no wind come. If the wind came to the tested stone, yeah. It's coming to your house.
There's no northeaster.
Yes. Whether it's the wind of your health going to be attacked, the wind of your resource, the wind of your family, one way or the other, I know the four winds are coming.
Perfect.
Are you listening to what I'm saying? Yeah. So my suggestion is to increase your faith. Grow in the knowledge of the Son of God. And if you're struggling, pray like the disciple. Oh Lord, help us with our lack of faith.
Yes.
Pray, oh Lord, increase the littleness of our faith. Amen. You go, oh you, amen. He asked him, oh you of little faith. Amen. Then he got up and rebuked the wind. He didn't stop the wind first. First he goes, why are you waking me up? Why can't you deal with it? Why can't you deal with the matter? Then after, the first time, he rebuked the wind, then he rebuked them. Now he rebuked them, then he deal with the wind.
I understand. Pastor Chow has been with me now quite a while. My wife has been with me now a while. In a short while, if my wife cannot deal with certain things, we got problems. We have problems. You know, you ask my wife, just with everything I'm learning, whether she likes it or not, she is equally learning. Mm-hmm. Amen? Because at a certain point, she is expected to able to do the things that I can do and better.
Pastor Chow has been with me a very long time. If he cannot testify or use faith, then both he and me have both wasted our time. I'm not surprised, as I said, what Jake is doing. She responds amazingly to the gospel, to grace. So our faith will carry her through. Do you understand the process?
Amen.
The more you hear the word and it get in, my wife prayed this morning. She prayed that the word of God doesn't fall on hard ground or rocks. But she always, in fact, she always prayed this prayer. She always prayed that it fall, amen, on soil that can observe it. Mm-hmm. Because the Bible said the enemy will try to steal it before they can what? Understand it, lay hold of it. Mm-hmm. Because once it falls, the Bible says it will produce, in good soil, it will produce what? An harvest. Church, remember 1 Corinthians 13:2. There is a faith that can move mountains. If the winds came to the Lord and it came to the disciple, I don't know what kind of wind you're going to face, but what I know, your approved faith is going to need to operate. So I can't put enough emphasis to tell you, your faith must get to approved state.
Yes.
I can't put enough emphasis to tell you, God is not pleased when your faith is not working. Satan will not stop if your faith doesn't work. And you will not experience. You're going to be like the disciple, afraid and timid and coward and agitated and anxious.
Mm-hmm.
Because you don't have a way to stop what? The wind. The Bible says God is at rest. Everything is done. He's waiting for you now to use your faith to overcome every situation. Are you listening to what I'm saying? Amen. Yeah. And yet he'll come in and he'll stop it. But he'll turn to you and go, why don't you have mountain faith? Listen the word of God. Read the word of God. Fellowship in the word of God. As we read in Timothy today. Aim and pursue.
Mm.
Amen? I want to close off by, this is more of an encouragement. Go to 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 22. And then let's take up tithing and communion. This is more of an encouragement for you. 2:2. 2 Timothy. I like the scripture personally. 2 Timothy 2:2. May we understand the principle and may we grow in grace. Shun youthful lust and flee from it. Youthful lust is like you're chasing everything and you're just distracted. When someone is young, you know, you want to do everything, you want to go every place, you want to see everything. This is called youthful lust, meaning it's just undisciplined, unmanaged, like it's like, you know, like free spiritness. The Bible says avoid it. It says shun youthful lust and flee from them. Now look at the second part. And aim, focus yourself, amen, at and pursue righteousness. We know faith comes, amen, faith leads to righteousness. So you go, pursue faith, amen. It says, aim and pursue righteousness, all that is virtuous, amen, and good, right living, conformity to the will of God in your thoughts, in your words and deeds. Say, God, pursue that which will conform you, focus you in your thoughts, your words and your deeds on God's will. And God said, my will is for you to have faith, approve faith. This is where Paul tells Timothy, fight the good fight of having approved faith.
Amen.
Amen. And then the scripture went on to say, amen, and aim at again and pursue what? Faith, love, and peace. It's a focus yourself, pursue righteousness, and pursue what? Faith, love, and peace. Now, please understand this. Growth doesn't happen by accident. Growth happens what?
Intentional.
Please understand this. I never see nobody muscle. Yes, your body grow to a natural proportion. But when someone's body is going to become defined,
development
doesn't happen naturally. It happens what? Intentional. Your body naturally grow. You understand? Your faculty naturally grow. But for them, the Bible said, your faculty must be trained in righteousness. You need to develop, aim, focus for your faith to grow. You naturally have faith, but it takes intentional application for it to what? Grow.
Amen.
The Bible said, pursue righteousness and pursue faith and pursue love and peace. Amen? which is harmony, concordance with others. Amen? Harmony and, amen, and concord with others in fellowship with all Christians who call upon the Lord. So you're going to need to intentionally go after righteousness. You're going to need to intentionally, amen, go after faith and love and peace. And these things are in Jesus. The more you pursue Jesus, the more you'll find him. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. I am trusting we all grow in grace. And we all fully understand how precious is your faith. The enemy is counting and you can't figure it out. We're going to stop there today. We're going to take up tithing and then we'll do communion. As usual, we thank those that watch us on the net. Amen. And you too. We thank God for your life. We trust the word bless you and your household. And may you learn the secret, the principle of faith. And may you learn to increase with it by pursuing righteousness, pursuing faith, love, and peace. By hearing the word of God, I mentioned 14 to you, you must grow in the knowledge of Jesus, which will allow you to live the overcomer's life. You must help others and you must learn to trust God more and more. And as you do this, amen, you will continue to be fruitful in every area and arena in your life. And anyone who have not accepted the Lord yet, I want to extend this chance for you. If right now, wherever you are, you believe that Jesus is the Son of God, and God raised him from the dead, and he's the Lord and the Christ, then you will be saved and saved to the uttermost. Jesus confessed before Pilate, Pilate God, are you, amen, the Christ, the King of the Jews? He said, and as you have said. So we want to join our faith with your faith, and as you believe, you and your household shall be saved, and may you increase in faith, approve faith, so you will please the heart of God, shut the enemy mouth, and enjoy the blessing of the Lord. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
That song is like the Lord demand. You got, I know faith can move mountains, and he's demanding the mountains in your life be moved. There are many mountains some of us have in our life. Mountains block your view. It's an hurdle you can't get over. And God will give you something that needs to be approved that he got, I want you to move the mountain. That's why some of us, the same thing happened in our life again and again. You're not removing the mountain. And that's it. You're trying to get around it without faith. God will never let it happen. Faith is the way of righteousness to move that mountain.
Amen.
You just speak to the mountain. Demand it move.
Amen.
And when you do that, that means you stand on the tested stone. You believe in the tested stone. Satan is trying to prove to you there's no tested stone, no one with authority and power to move over a mountain. In Jesus' name. Let's stand for prayer. The Lord said, if you have this communion without realizing he's a tested stone for your benefit, the stone that brought you back to God, the stone that upholding you, sustaining. This way he said, apart from him, you can't do nothing. He said, if you don't believe in who I am, that I'm the Son of God, and God raised me from the dead, amen, and he's the Lord, meaning owner, and the Christ, the appointed one to deal with everything, amen, and everything is unto him, and he has given you authority and power. Amen. That serpents and scorpions can't hurt you or harm you. And then he said, if you don't believe those things, you shouldn't have my communion.
Mm-hmm.
Because the communion is gratefulness of all of this.
Mm.
He said, I've given you Christ's sufficiency, making you equal to everything and anything. Let's pray. Father, we're so grateful to participate in your communion. We're so grateful for who you are.
Yes.
That you are God. The sanctified, the living one, the eternal one, the one that is established to be praised and adored. We're so grateful. What is man? You're so mindful. All you have done for us, you create us, we betray you. You sent Jesus to atone for our betrayal. You reconcile us. Oh, we consider your mercies to us. He paid the penalty. We get the blessing. We lose our life, but you give us the very life and spirit of Jesus. So that we can commune, walk with you. The only thing you ask us is to maintain the testimony. You say, I have summoned you in such a time to maintain the testimony. That God still is. God has sent for Jesus. Jesus has atoned for us. Jesus has been raised from the dead. Jesus is coming back, and Jesus continued to live in us through the Holy Spirit, giving us everything we need for life and spirituality. You continuously reveal yourself, so we have deep, personal, precise knowledge, so we can grow in grace, so we can move from faith to faith, according to righteousness, strength to strength, victory to victory. Our life is a testimony that you are the tested stone. We thank you today for approval. Faith.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you today for the genuineness of our faith.
Yes, Lord.
That we can overcome any and every mountain.
Hallelujah.
That comes against us or stand in our way. We thank you for the faith and the love that you have removed all fearfulness and all timidness away from us. We're not afraid to take on situations, circumstances, and conditions, because faith gives us the boldness that is founded in Jesus, that we can take them on in the name of Jesus. We thank you for overcoming every situation, every circumstance, every condition, every area and arena in our life, Father, that need to be taken. We are taking the mountain in the name of Jesus. Father, today let this communion be clean and acceptable unto you. We commit it into your hands in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name. You know, I once read a saint said this. He said, if the enemy defeats you in your health, you have lost some, but it's not that bad. If he defeats you in your resource, or if he defeats you in your resource, it's not that bad. If he defeats you in your health, it's not that bad. You know, your health is important. But if he defeats you in your faith, there's a significant loss, because it's both spiritual and physical. Understand? Resource is just defeat in one dimension. Your health, again, this dimension. But if he defeats you in your faith, church, if he defeats you in the preciousness, your loss is unimaginable.
Mm-hmm.
Unimaginable. The kingdom lost, you lost, people lost, trampling over the accomplished work. That loss is significant, which means that's where you fight the hardest. Amen. I pray you don't have no loss, not in your health or your resource, but I especially ask God not to let you suffer loss in your faith.
Hallelujah.
That's what Christ prayed for Peter.
Yes, that his faith won't fail him. That's what the prayer Christ prayed for Peter.
One prayer.
Yes, he said, Peter, the enemy keep asking to sift you, but I'm going to pray that your faith will not fail you. Luke chapter 1. Amen. Let's eat. As we eat with grateful recognition that this bread symbolizes body. And equally, we drink of his cup, that again, with such grateful appreciation that his blood atoned for us and brought us into right standing with our God. Let's drink. Pastor Chow is about to pray, and before he pray, I'm going to put two scripture in your spirit. It's like putting something in your safe. The one Pastor Chow just quote, Luke 22:31. Luke 22:31, the Bible reads, Simon, Simon, Peter, listen. Satan has asked excessively that all of you, it wasn't just Peter he was asking for actually alone, he was asking for all the disciples be given up to him out of the power and keeping of God. So Satan has going, if they're not protected by your power, I will show you they have no faith. Because God protects us just like, you know, Charles and Jing and Sister Claire protect our children, that they wouldn't get open to the danger. Until God knows you can handle it, he does not let you out. Amen? The Bible said that he might sift all of you like grains. In Amos 9:9, God said this. God will allow it. God said this. For behold, I will command, and I will sift the house of Israel among all nations, and cause it to move to and fro as grain is sifted in a sieve. Yet shall not the least kernel fall upon the earth. Amen? And be lost. God said, I will allow you to be sifted, but I will never allow you to be what? Lost.
Thank you, Jesus.
You know, you guys know it's a safe. I know, Mama Claire, you know. We put stuff in and we just shake it around.
You take out all,
in a sense, God, so any area in your life that does not fit, I'm going to allow it to be safe. But I ain't going to allow none of it to be what? Loss. God don't want you to suffer loss, but He want every area to have faith. This He demand. This He command. Amen? May we have faith.